Hey, Vinyl Community, it's Vance here, and this is a response video for Maggie and her 300 subs contest. Hello, Maggie. Just wanted to say, congrats on, getting more subscribers. Obviously, everybody's finding out about your channel and loves your enthusiasm and what you bring. It's always great to see more ladies in the VC. I wanted to answer the questions that you had. You asked for music that stops us in our tracks. You asked for album artwork, album artwork that we love, but we don't like the music, and then album artwork we don't like, but we like the music, I think. And also movie music or soundtracks that we're really into or something like that. Okay, I'm going to start with, the obvious choice, the music that kind of stops you in your tracks. Now, I don't have any, this can go anyway. There's a ton of songs that, take you back, obviously. That's what music does, it's a soundtrack to our life. So, there's a song, Band on the Run by McCartney and Wings. That takes me back to, being a kid in the summer and going to the town pool, the local pool, and hanging out there over summer, songs like that, and Summer Breeze, that song is the same thing, there's songs that remind me of high school, there's songs that remind me of college, girlfriends, things like that. But there's always, and this one's probably, you can guess what I'm going to say, but there's always one band that basically stops me in my tracks, and I, anytime it comes on, I listen to it, no matter how many times I've heard the songs. And that, of course, you guessed it, Led Zeppelin. It never fails, even my wife, we'll be in the car, and it'll come on, and I'll have to say, hey, wait a minute, we can't get out of the car until the song's over, or she goes, well, we just heard that song at home or something, and we get in the car, and it's playing again. Why are we listening to it again? You just heard it. Sorry, you gotta listen to it again. So that's just, it's just the way it is, man, So Led Zeppelin, any tune stops me in my tracks, and I gotta listen to it. All right, so then let's go with this. We'll do the album covers. It was hard to find one that an album cover that I had that I liked the album cover, but I didn't like the music. So I'm kind of going on a stretch here, but I did have this, and it was kind of odd. This is Barbie Benton. It's called Barbie Doll. She was a Playboy Playmate. And this is actually on Playboy Records. You can see there, little bunny. And it's kind of one of the reasons why I still have this. Obviously, she was cute, back in the day. But it also came with a poster, of her. A little dress there and stuff. But also kind of what I like about this, it's on Playboy Records, so it has this freaking awesome, Playboy inner sleeve, and the Playboy label. So, as for the music, not my thing really. I don't even know if I've listened to this really, all the way through, but it's it's just her singing, which she wasn't really known for being a singer. It was just, Hugh Hefner, or probably, she said she wanted to be a singer, and Hugh would do whatever he had to do for him, So, Barbie Benton, Barbie Doll, nice cover, music, not so much. Now, this one, I'm going to go a step further. I love the band, the music, I hated the album cover, and in fact, I hated the band's name. It still bothers me to this day when these guys came out. I think these guys should have never have gotten or did the makeup thing and the whole hair band thing or anything like that. They should have just kind of stuck to the type of band they are, which to me was more of a bluesy rock band instead of getting into the hair stuff. I'm talking about Cinderella. Hate the name Cinderella. Whenever somebody asks me, what's the worst band name? Cinderella. It just doesn't fit this band when you listen to some of their stuff. And this album cover, look at that. It's just so cheesy. I hate it. But I love the songs. You know, I mean, you had some of the big songs were Night Songs, Shake Me, Nobody's Fool. But other ones like Somebody Save Me, In From the Outside, Push Push. I mean, those were great, you know, good old-fashioned rock songs, really. But they got, you know, obviously, and by their look, they were just, you know, getting clumped into the hair band thing. So later on in their career, once their second album came out, Long Cold Winter, they kind of pulled back from the hair band stuff and had more of a bluesier sound to them. And then even after that, with Shelter Me and their album after that, I forgot the name, you know, they broke away from that. But still, Cinderella, come on. So, never was a fan of this album cover or the band name, but I love the music. Good stuff. All right, and then the last thing you asked us was about movie music. And I'm going to, there's so many, obviously, that you can go with this. But I'm going to go with a movie that I just loved when I was a kid, but it was not allowed to watch until, like, it came out on video or cable or something like that. I didn't go to the theaters because there was so much controversy around this film. And there's, you know, there was all these talks about fights breaking out in the theater and everything. But when I listen to, you know, when I watch the movie and some of the music that's on here, I mean, that's what I think of. In fact, the title song, I guess, well, not title song, but the song at the end and the credits, every time I hear it, I think about this, and it just kind of reminds me of the film and just the whole setting of it, you know. I'm talking about the film The Warriors, and here's the soundtrack. All right, and the song, the main song that kicks in at the end of the credits after, you know, I don't know if you've seen this movie, but the song by Joe Walsh called In the City. Just, I mean, I'm not sure, I almost think he wrote it for this movie and then they re-recorded it for the Eagles, the Long Run album. But, you know, I'd have to go back and do the research on that, what came first. But the music for this film is just great. There's some other stuff on here. The theme for Warriors, just this kind of creepy, you know, Moog kind of keyboard thing going on. And also the scene with the baseball fury chase is great. You know, the music to that just creeps you out when, you know, you see these painted guys, these baseball fury gang, and they're chasing the Warriors down the street and this music's playing. If I can, I'll put the links below to some film clips. The music for the Warriors was always a favorite. There's some other songs in here, Nowhere to Run. It just fit, you know. I love the music in here. I love the film. It's one of those cult classic films, I guess. So that's one of them. I mean, there's others I can mention, you know. Another one was Apocalypse Now, you know, and this actually, here's the soundtrack for that. This didn't have a lot of music in it. What this album, actually, the soundtrack, is a lot of the dialogue and then the music. So the opening scenes with, you know, playing music from the Doors, the song The End is in here, and then you have some other... you know, Ride of the Valkyries during one of the main helicopter battle scenes, you know, are great in here. But some of that music, too, when I hear Ride of the Valkyries, I think of this, you know, music, you know. That I think of those helicopters, man, those helicopters coming across, you know. I mean, it's an iconic film scene with the music that just, you know, you hear that music and that's what you think of. At least that's what I do. There's other ones, you know. Jerry Reed, Eastbound and Down for Smokey and the Bandit. Come on. That's like, to me, anytime we go on a trip, I gotta play that song. You know? We're Eastbound and Down, you know. Boys in Atlanta, you know, they're thirsty. We got a long way to go and a short time to get there. So, those are some of the things that I thought, you know, maybe I'd let you know about. And hope you like that, you know, kind of get an idea there. But I tell you, you know, these guys, I could hear even Stairway to Heaven. You know, I'll listen to it in the car if I hear. But you know, and how many? I can't tell you how many times I've heard that song. And really, kind of, you know, I think Tom Kiefer actually has gone solo now, so the name Cinderella ain't going to be around anymore. And my movie music, Warriors. Check, if you haven't seen this film, check it out. It's about a street gang in New York that gets accused of killing a leader of a big gang. They got to fight their way back to Coney Island. Came out in 1979, so some of it, I don't know, it holds up pretty well, I think. But that's me. All right, well, that's my entry. Congratulations, Maggie. All I can say is, you know, it's your enthusiasm and your sweetness and kindness and everything in the VC is great. Enjoy, you know, the videos you do, and it's cool to see your collection grow. You know, in every video, you're like, you got the vinyl bug. So take care, and we'll see you around. Rock on.